as our WWE superstars are jockeying for position. Going into the upcoming pay-per-view event, we welcome you tonight to Monday Night Raw.
Without question, one of the most anticipated episodes.
All right, guys, so here we go for tonight's matches. We got Kevin Owens versus Damian Priest, Rhea Ripley versus Nia Jax, Kane versus Braun Strowman, the Hart Foundation versus the Hurt Business, Seth Rollins versus Brock Lesnar, and Omos, who attacked the Undertaker, which caused him, we didn't even get the main event in, as Undertaker and Hogan will team up against Omos and Stone Cold Steve Austin. So let's go ahead and get Raw underway here tonight.
This just became the KO show.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring from Marieville, Quebec, Canada, weighing in at 266 pounds, Kevin Owens!
Kevin Owens used to fight for himself and his family. Now he fights against authority and everything Shane McMahon stands for. Kevin Owens cares about no one but himself. And that's why he's successful. From the underground of New York City, Damian Priest has arrived. Calm demeanor, but about to unleash chaos.
And his opponent from New York, New York, weighing in at 249 pounds, Damian Priest.
Damian Priest has a martial arts background, pure brawling power. Priest aims to live forever. He's never scared of a fight, not starting now. Priest's rise is your demise. Beware the archer of infamy. Kevin Owens is the kind of guy who never hesitates to speak his mind, though it has landed him in trouble more than a few times in the past.
Luckily, KO is also the kind of guy who is always ready to back up anything he says with his actions in the ring.
True, and I'm sure Owens was doing plenty of jawing backstage heading into this match. It'll be fun to see how he backs it up.
And across the ring, we've got Damian Priest, a man whose size and agility make him complex to overcome.
A man of his size, Damian Priest has no business moving the way he does. But somehow, Priest is capable of doing so and has profited greatly from it. I'm sure we'll see his size and agility be a factor tonight.
Priest able to adapt.
There's a takedown.
When facing an opponent like Damian Priest, it seems like the cards are stacked against you for this.
From the top!
Oh, piercing elbow.
Forearm to the face.
Oh, nothing fancy about that.
Oh, what a roundhouse.
The damage he's taken is starting to pile up.
South of heaven.
was an awesome win for this young man. One of the biggest in his career by far.
What a battle. Respect to both competitors.
And this I love. This I absolutely love. Maybe you should have taken a page out of that kid's book in your career, Corey. Great sportsmanship.
I would have hit him in the mouth.
Good matchup to start Raw. Damian Priest steals, gets a big win over Kevin Owens here on Raw. Next, it's Rhea Ripley versus Nia Jax.
Now the nightmare is real.
Rash, bold, and unashamed. Brutality has arrived.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Making her way to the ring from Adelaide, Australia, Rhea Ripley.
The first ever woman to hold the NXT UK Championship has gone on to hold the NXT Women's Championship and the Raw Women's title.
And let's not forget the first NXT competitor to ever put their title on the line at WrestleMania.
Sent a message to the entire world in the 2017 and 2018 Mae Young Classic tournaments. The irresistible force is on Raw.
And from San Diego, California, Nia Jax!
There is no one else quite like Nia Jax. The only competitor to be in the Men and Women's Rumble on the same night. Yeah! Nia Jax straight up runs things in the women's division. Going to impose her will on anyone in that ring tonight. Nia Jax in the ring, the powerhouse of the women's division. Nia absolutely loves to impose her will over her peers here in WWE.
Cole, I think you mean she loves to impose her will over the competition here in WWE. And not just her will, Cole, her size, her strength, her power.
That's true, and absolutely dominant competitor is Nia Jax. Tonight promises to be no different for her.
But across the ring is any superstar's nightmare. Rhea Ripley, a competitor with a remarkable strength and a mean streak to match it. Overcoming Ripley's incredible talents and brutal tactics tonight, it's going to be a tall order.
What a chop!
That'll light up your chest.
Flapjack!
Face first.
And she knew Ripley's game plan.
Uh-oh. Carefully measured.
Oh, man! Leg drop arm breaker. Some superstars in the back would argue that Nia Jax has a bit of an ego. Corey, do you see that being a factor in this matchup tonight?
Well, I'll make sure Nia knows that you said that about her, Corey, but to humor you, I'll admit that sometimes Nia gets too confident in her shots at success over the course of a match, only for it to backfire. A vigilant opponent will look past Nia's confidence and keep the pressure on the irresistible force. That's what needs to happen here.
Oh, what a right!
Man, that's some attitude behind it.
Oh! Ripley's strength being nullified with moves like that.
Yeah, Nia making clear she has absolutely no problem using her power game to her advantage.
Right across the face. Targeting the throat there.
Just unloading knees to the body.
What a kick.
Jax with great wherewithal.
Reciprocating the initial reversal.
Riptide.
Into the pin attack.
Two.
Sends off the three count.
That was a long two count there.
For the submission. Look at this power.
The prison trap is in.
May have just vanquished the irresistible force.
Is she gonna tap, 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 tap? And she escapes the submission.
Oh, that'll leave a mark.
Oh, Ripley put a stop to that.
Position after some early overconfidence. Clearly didn't expect her opponent to remain so vigilant.
Oh, by the hair! Whipped across the ring.
Hey.
Gets to the ropes and that's it. Got the shoulders down.
One, two,
digging deep for a kick out.
She just won't stay down. I think we're about to see it. Muscles them all the way up.
Oh, a down powerbomb.
And now it's all Nia.
She's going up.
Top rope here.
Taking flight.
Splash.
Nia Jackson, a leg drop. Thunderous leg drop.
And she saw that coming from Jax.
Refocusing to reverse that.
Ooh, she just turned it around.
Arm trapped. Burying knees into the body.
Whoa, right to the kidneys.
The end is looming.
Rhea looking to end this one right now. This will do it. The prism trap is in. Look at the power of the nightmare.
How in the world can you get Nia in a submission hold?
I didn't think we'd see it. But a tap out.
And Ripley earns the W.
Here is your winner, Rhea Ripley.
And this victory is one for the record books.
This win tonight may have been a career-defining moment. They're definitely celebrating like it was.
Here comes the big red
following contest is scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring from parts unknown, weighing in at 323 pounds, Kane!
One of the most dominant, destructive forces in the history of WWE. Multiple world and tag team championships, and more destruction to come. Uh-oh, batten down the hatches. Destruction is imminent.
And his opponent from Sherrill's Ford, North Carolina, weighing in at 385 pounds, Braun Strowman!
Won many titles, including the Universal Championship.
Yeah, but sometimes I feel like Braun Strowman is more interested in just causing pain.
The monster is about to be unleashed. Brace yourself for impact.
You look at Kane and you're looking at a tormented soul, a demon whose every attack is an assault on all of humanity. Kane is always searching for his next victim. Terror awaits in any match with a big red machine.
But there in the ring with a human wrecking ball, Braun Strowman, a man who devastates anything and anyone that would dare get in his way.
Trucks, ambulances, all reduced to rubble by Strowman. But if you think what he does to machines is bad, wait till you see Braun gets his hands on his opponent tonight.
Nito! Man, that hurts!
Yeah. Oh, Kane counters.
No! That'll break his arm. Vicious.
Now look at his aggression, just pure brutality.
Come on, easy.
Kane with some good timing here. Boom, just turn that around.
Heave the side. Jeez.
Oh, hold on. Is he thinking of a submission here?
Really working that.
He got locked in.
He may not have a choice.
Nice escape.
Reversal. Can he take advantage?
Looking wobbly in the corner.
Ooh, that'll kill you. Over. Kane takes people apart limb by limb. Corey, is there anything that can be done to avoid such a gruesome demise?
Yeah, run. Use whatever agility you have to avoid Kane's devastating offense and strike fast when you find a weakness, because you're not going to overpower the big red machine.
Just like that, Braun gets pounced on.
Really just laying it in.
Oh, he's got him here. He's got him up.
And oh!
No, that'll break his arm. Vicious.
Strowman. This is not going to be good at all.
Oh, Braun Strowman slamming into the mat.
Strowman.
He's going for the pin. This could be it.
Into the pay window.
Two. No, stops the count at two.
Good Lord, scarily close to three.
Oh, my
look at
goodness.
This. From the ground up.
Superhuman.
No way Kane is going to recover from that. Unshakable, undeterred, the big red monster rises again.
Strowman is going to have to readjust, going to have to consider his next move, questioning what more he must do. Got him set up in the corner of the ring.
Uh-oh.
Face first in the turnbuckle.
And Strowman was the one getting wrecked there.
Yeah, well, that's Kane bringing terror to the competition.
Huge boot.
And this has got to be it. Shoulder shoots up before two.
I'm just as shocked as everyone else, Cole. His opponent included.
Kick lands. Strong counters are Strowman.
Kane keeps him away.
Quick exchange of counters there.
Strowman just here beat down Kane.
Braun Strowman!
Braun Strowman with the victory. What a matchup!
A win like that proved he is not messing around.
That match was all business from him, Corey, and that worked.
Big win for Braun Strowman, looking to get himself into the United States title picture. The win on Raw. Alright guys, here we go. Number one contendership. Possibly for the tag team titles, the Hart Foundation versus the Hurt Business. Of Cedric Alexander and Shelton Benjamin.
Team in WWE history.
The following contest is a tag team match scheduled for one fall on the way to the ring at a combined weight of 516 pounds. Bret the Hitman Hart and Jim the Anvil Neidhart, the Hart Foundation.
A true Hall of Fame tag team when you look at Bret the Hitman Hart and Jim the Anvil Neidhart.
And their opponents at a combined weight of 448 pounds, Shelton Benjamin and Cedric Alexander, the Hurt Business.
The tag team division here has never been more competitive. Every team needs to deliver an emphatic message each week. School tonight with a little two-on-two tag team action.
Doesn't get any more classic than this. You truly get the best of both worlds, and sometimes pairings you really didn't see coming. Hey, kind of like you and me, boy.
I would very much like to be excluded from this narrative, Saxton.
Setting up.
Reaches his partner for the tag.
Yeah. Xander answers back. A knee right to the face.
That knee is a lethal weapon.
Oh, right to the kidneys. Strikes with a kick. Saw that one coming. Both superstars showing great awareness of their opponent's repertoire. He saw it coming, taking advantage. Counters. He takes control. Cutting it back with their own counter. Hart in a defenseless position.
It's a knuckle driver.
Penny predicament, shoulders down, and fends off the pinfall.
Trying to make short order of things there.
And setting him up. Knee to the ace.
That's going to hurt. Hitman expected that.
And an inverted atomic drop. Oh, my God. Oh, and a backbreaker.
Right to the spine.
Brett is not finding a way to gain the edge.
The Hitman is showing some vulnerabilities in his game.
And he saw that coming from Cedric.
Brett showing how much punishment he can withstand before getting his own offense in.
Brett could be turning his fortunes around.
Fresh man in.
Oh, yeah, here we go.
Finish it off.
No, that'll break his arm. Vicious.
Oh, stomping away.
This match grinding him down a little. See the drop kick.
An elusive Benjamin there.
Benjamin connecting with a shot.
Ooh, that was nasty.
Ooh, sharp elbow.
Oh, Anvil anticipated that.
Dominating shoulder tackle.
Get him into the corner. He's struggling a bit here.
These two teams have gone to war, Cole. Of course they're going to wind up with a few battle scars.
And he saw that coming from Cedric. And here's Hart sent flying and into a rough landing. He's in off the tag. From the middle rope.
Brett was waiting for it.
Big forearm.
Whoa! Drop kick all the way to the outside.
In control here with a swinging neck breaker.
Textbook.
Out.
Four.
let him have this moment. He's earned it. Sliding back into the action. Hart wasting no motion on the counter. Reversal after reversal. These two are ready for each other. Right to the kidneys from behind. Shifts it back out to him. In control here with a swinging neck breaker. Textbook. And Brett is still taking the fight to his opponent.
Shelton has to gather himself, has to regain some composure, like now.
He catches Shelton with a counter. Oh, God, what an elbow. At this juncture, you have to wonder if these superstars can keep up this pace.
They're certainly being taken into the deep waters now.
Elbow lands hard. Just deadlifting right there. The power. Power slam. No doubt the anvil ended this.
There's two.
Just breaking down the opponent. And just like that, he sent crashing to the floor.
On display, guys.
The Hart Foundation will challenge RK-Bro for the tag team titles in the near future. What a matchup here on Raw. Alright, up next, ladies and gentlemen, Seth Rollins is here in an angry Brock Lesnar, who was the first man eliminated at the Money in the Bank. He has been furious wanting to get back. He's going against the man that won the Money in the Bank, Seth Rollins, although Seth Rollins is not going to put the Money in the Bank on the line tonight. Let's see what happens.
It's Mr. Money in the Bank.
His way to the ring from Davenport, Iowa, weighing in at 217 pounds, Seth Rollins.
The WWE Universe has been counting the days, hours, and minutes for this match to start, and the countdown is almost over.
He is in perhaps the best shape of his career, and he will need that with the competition level this high.
Seth Rollins, who won the Money in the Bank. And here comes the Beast, Brock Lesnar.
His opponent from Minneapolis, Minnesota, weighing in at 295 pounds, Brock Lesnar.
Yeah. To quote Pat McAfee, he looks like Brock Lesnar ate Brock Lesnar.
Think about this. Brock Lesnar spent over 16 months away from WWE after losing the WWE Championship, and now the Beast Incarnate looks hungrier than ever.
No emotion, no remorse, just simply poised for absolute destruction. That is the Beast Incarnate, Brock Lesnar, to a T.
Transpired between Seth Rollins and Brock Lesnar for years. Lesnar had a stranglehold on the Universal Championship until his match with Rollins at WrestleMania. We knew it would come down to this, the aftermath.
Tonight, Brock Lesnar is looking to avenge his loss to Rollins at WrestleMania. Some say it puts the Beast Slayer behind the eight ball. Seth Rollins disagrees and has a ton of steam heading into this match.
Pulls the trigger. Puts with a knee right to the face. Is it enough?
He's determined to keep this matchup going.
If this lands, it's over. Oh, that hurt. What a counter. Crash landing. No! That'll break his arm. Vicious. Fighting the Beast back. Stops the kick. Clothesline. And Rollins capitalizes. Kick gets caught. Lesnar's the Beast. He's the conqueror. But Brock must be aware of Seth Rollins' speed and quickness and Seth's ability to endure tremendous punishment and keep fighting.
Seth Rollins is very familiar with Suplex City and its confines. Lesnar must prevent Rollins from utilizing his ability to strike from the ground and the air. That could keep Lesnar off balance all night.
Seth Rollins knows he can't stand toe-to-toe with the Beast. The Beast knows Rollins can't stand toe-to-toe with him. Lesnar only has to defend against any of Seth's desperate low tactics.
Just carrying the opposition anywhere they want. Down on the windpipe.
Now trampling the opposition.
Rollins got out of the way.
Foot to the midsection.
What a counter.
He reverses it. Lesnar with a whip. Ooh, and a reversal.
Vicious right forward.
Seth Rollins may be looking. Oh, there it is. Ripcord knee.
What magic. And he goes for the pin. Two. Big kick out.
At this point in the match, that could have gone either way.
Rollins just a step too slow.
He switches it back around.
Waiting for a little bit of high risk here, it seems.
Desperate attempt here to get back on his feet.
Up high.
Lesnar gets out of the way.
Is there any fight left in Rollins?
And Brock is bewildered. Brock has no clue how that just happened.
Guys, I have a feeling someone is about to get their chest caved in.
I think it's happening. My goodness.
He's getting pushed down into the defensive.
At this stage of the match, they are clearly starting to feel the effects of this back and forth.
Versatility from Rollins. Bad predicament right here. Oh, bang! Face first.
Two.
Enabled to counter. Climbs back into the ring. Seth Rollins up the turnbuckles. From the top.
Between the Beast and the Beast Slayer.
And it's not over yet.
Using the rope to their advantage.
Very effective.
They can just punch him in the chest.
Look out.
Stop. Rollins just turned the lights out.
He's on the ropes. The official sees it and waves off the pin.
Technique reversing Rollins.
And responds with a counter of their own.
These superstars have toiled away endlessly, and this crowd is on their feet in full appreciation.
An incredible sight to see.
Are we keeping track?
Byron, grab your little dog and warn your aunt.
F5.
Oh, my.
Brock could be seconds away.
Kick out. I can't believe what we're seeing from Seth Rollins tonight.
And now Lesnar's just angrier. You only tick off the Beast by making yourself a difficult prey.
Brock with the quick wherewithal.
Seth Rollins not looking so good here.
Dangerous times for the architect.
Might want to walk it off or shake it off or do whatever he needs to do to get his head in the game here.
Yeah, all the architect's designs seem to be going astray.
Got to figure out a new plan quick.
Brace for impact. Here it comes.
The Beast incarnate with a...
Bang!
Going to the well again. Will it produce...
Lesnar!
The Beast Incarnate was all over Seth Rollins, and Lesnar's brutality was ungodly. His appetite to destroy Rollins was insatiable, and we witnessed the end result.
We saw here tonight the will Brock Lesnar has, the desire Brock Lesnar possesses to annihilate his opponents, especially when that opponent is Seth Rollins.
What a matchup between the two. That first, it took three F5s from Brock to take out Seth Rollins. Seth Rollins put up a well of a fight tonight. But Brock Lesnar, that F5 catching Seth Rollins in midair, that changed this entire matchup. Brock Lesnar wins here on Raw. Alright guys, here we go. Tornado tag, Austin and Omos versus Hogan and The Undertaker. We will have the number one contendership for the WWE Championship next week on Raw between Hogan and The Undertaker. Let's get this match underway.
The leader of the Attitude Era, the Rattlesnake.
The following contest is a tornado tag team match. Introducing first, from Victoria, Texas, weighing in at 252 pounds, the WWE Champion, Stone Cold Steve Austin.
A multi-time world champion, former King of the Ring, first three-time Royal Rumble winner.
The Texas Rattlesnake is synonymous with truly epic main event brawls.
And I think we're about to see another one of those main event brawls here tonight. Many believe Stone Cold is the greatest of all time. One of the tallest competitors in WWE history.
The personification of intimidation, the Colossus, has arrived.
And his partner, from Lagos, Nigeria, weighing in at 400 pounds, Omos!
You want to talk about how dominant Omos has been already in his WWE career? This is a man who won the Raw Tag Team titles in his debut match, which took place at WrestleMania.
And in the days since, Omos has scored major wins against superstars the caliber of Riddle, even his former tag team partner, the phenomenal AJ Styles.
Towers over the entire locker room, both literally and figuratively.
Who in the world can take down this Colossus known as Omos?
Oh boy, look who's here. The Phenom has arrived. And demise awaits anyone who stands across the ring from the dead man. The Reaper walks among us.
And from Death Valley, weighing in at 299 pounds, the Undertaker!
The magnificence of the Phenom. Truly a mesmerizing scene. The legendary Phenom creates an atmosphere unlike anything you will see. Talk to anyone who's ever been in the ring opposite The Undertaker, and they will tell you nothing prepares you for this. The stoic walk of the dead man.
You know, Undertaker is a time-honored warrior of the ring.
No matter what you do, I'm not sure there's anything that prepares you for the Undertaker.
So many superstars have stood across the ring from the dead man, paralyzed with fear. Abandon all hope. The dead man has risen.
Omos attacked the Undertaker before the Undertaker could have a match against Hogan. After what happened at Money in the Bank 1 week ago. And here comes Hogan's tag team partner. The man who will challenge Stone Cold Steve Austin at Backlash.
Gentlemen, Hulkamania is about to run wild.
There is only one, the immortal. And from Venice Beach, California, weighing in at 302 pounds, Hogan.
So between WCW and WWE, Hogan has had double-digit world title reigns.
Not to mention, he's a two-time WWE Hall of Famer and the biggest name in the business in the 80s and 90s.
WWE Universe is going crazy.
I don't understand why all this hot dogging and grandstanding already. The match hasn't even begun yet.
Don't you know, Corey, Hogan feeds off the energy from the WWE Universe. It's going to power him through this match. And by the way, what you going to do when Hulkamania runs wild on you? That's pretty good, right?
No, terrible. At least you and Hogan have the same hairline.
All right, here we go. Stone Cold and Omos. Stone Cold being forced to team up with Omos to take on Hogan and The Undertaker.
In this tornado tag competition tonight, we are going to see
Austin and Hogan.
And Omos. And standing in their way of victory, we see The Undertaker and Hulk Hogan.
There is absolutely nothing that can prepare you for the brutality that could take place in a match like this.
I absolutely agree. With every ticking second, the risk of injury increases, and you have to not only look out for your own safety, but your partner's as well.
Ooh, that might have just broken something.
Backslam. Oh, a big uppercut.
Inflicting more damage to the leg.
Steve Austin started to flounder some.
Big boot.
These two showing how well scouted they each are.
Overhand connects. Finds a counter for the dead man.
They just punch him in the chest.
Oh, man. Referee hit hard here.
Oh, the counter.
Dominating shoulder tackle.
Nice counter by Austin.
Hogan out of the way in time.
Inverted atomic drop.
Austin and Hogan will face each other at Backlash for the WWE Championship.
Right now, just carried like a rag doll here. Here's a cover. Could be it.
Hogan reportedly suffered a minor injury after the pay-per-view.
Oh,
Oh, Hell's Gate on Austin. And Omos now going after the Undertaker. Austin and Hogan going at it. Austin Hogan for the WWE Championship at Backlash. Hogan got a shoulder up.
No way, no way. I refuse to believe that wasn't three.
Stunner on Hogan. Austin beats Hogan.
Touches on this one for the win.
These men really rose
a unique team, but the WWE champion pins his challenger at Backlash. What will happen next week on Raw? We will find out then. All right, so that's Raw in the books. Up next.